Welcome to another Driving in MacArthur. Today we have our Group Fixed Operations Manager in the car with us, Gary Thompson. Hey Gaz.
How you going?
You know, fantabulously fantastic.
As always.
Yeah. A little bit different this time with the current conditions around the COVID-19. We've decided to try and do a bit of spatial separation, and hence you're in the back seat. So
Correct.
I'm the taxi rider. You could call me Mr. Uber, I guess, at the moment. And today we're jumping around in a Mitsubishi PHEV, PHEV, a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, which I'll probably talk about a bit more later on. I know a lot about you because you've been with us for a long time. When did you start with us the first time?
I think that was back in 2002, I think it was, 2001.
Okay. For a little while?
For a little while, until 2006.
And you moved up to...
Moved back to Queensland.
Yep.
For a couple of years.
That's right, you are a Queenslander in terms of supporting the Maroons, which is always a bone of contention when footy is on.
Well, that is correct.
You're that guy.
But you know, no one's taken the sign down yet, so that's fine.
Queensland for a bit, and then came back. Sydney,
yeah. Jostled around a little bit, and then came back to Wakelands and been here for 13 odd years now.
How long in total do you reckon that is?
It'd be close to 20 years all up.
Yeah, I would have thought so. So you manage the fixed ops part of our business, which for people out there is what we call our service and parts divisions. So primarily, how many people do you reckon would be under your sort of direct reporting? It'd be 100 odd, easy?
Yeah, at the present moment, yes.
Yeah. So a bit about you. So married, kids, pets, hobbies,
Yes.
I know all of them. So, I kind of feel like I could tell your story, but this is about you telling your story.
So married, been married for quite a few years.
A long time.
Been with my wife I'll
call her now.
I think it's about 32 years all up.
Yeah.
But three kids. Two girls and a boy. One's still at high school. Two are out working, so that's great. Pets, we've got a few dogs. Got birds. Had chickens for a little while.
Yeah.
Got lizards.
Yeah.
Horses.
We've had great success in our Volkswagen franchise throughout the years, mainly because of our people. And a couple of times we've been lucky enough to be recognised as a dealer of the year or a premium dealer, as they now call it. National premium dealer a couple of times, four times now.
Gosh.
And part of that success was a lot of the effort that you put in, Gaz, specifically, and were acknowledged for that with the receiving the gold pin, weren't you?
That's correct.
So a couple of years ago, was it last year or a couple of years ago?
Two years ago.
You got a gold pin. So around the world, Volkswagen recognised specific people. I'm not sure how many there are now, though. It's like 10 a year sort of thing, and you got one.
Yes, correct.
Good
correct.
On you.
Yeah, there's not a great deal of service managers or fixed operations managers that have actually got one.
I can't think of any.
It's very few, yeah.
Yeah, and it just goes to show how high they hold you in their regard.
Yeah.
Well done, Gaz. We're proud
good.
Of you.
That was good. No, thank you.
So if we might just turn our thoughts, I guess, to the current situation that the world finds itself in, and it's a horrible situation. One of the things we've tried to do is make sure that everyone knows that we're going to get through it and we're still open for business and we're all on the same team. And how would you say, can you give us an example about how we're looking after customers' concerns in the current environment?
Yeah, so at the present moment, when a customer comes in for service, like we do driveway service, when the customer comes in, we make sure that we stand a bit away from the car. We reassure the customer that what we're doing with the alcohol wipes, so we wipe down the steering wheels, the gear knobs, the handbrake lever, the door handles, window switches, exterior door handle, do a steering wheel wrap around the steering wheel to make sure it's all protected.
Yep.
The guys are all wearing gloves, rubber gloves at the same time, and on handover to the vehicle back to the customer, it's also wiped back down again with another alcohol wipe just to make sure that everything is fine for the customer. We start with the key because that's the most touch component, and that's always handed over to the customer without us touching it while it's still in the alcohol wipe. Then go out and take all the protective meshes off the car, from the seat cover, the floor mat, the steering wheel wrap, and give the steering wheel another wipe down, the infomedia system, gear lever, handbrake, interior and exterior door handles again.
Yeah, so as comprehensive as we think we can be with what we know at the moment. A couple other things would be our loan cars and our courtesy bus.
We'll have a micro bulb that goes off into them.
Yep. So we're going to try and demonstrate that a bit later so people know what that looks like.
And we set those off because that actually kills a lot of the germs that are in the car, and it also lasts for a period of time as well.
Yeah, it's not a permanent solution, but it's not a temporary one either.
No, that's right.
Yeah. So we've changed things like we're now working on split shifts, so we've got two workforces in play.
Yes.
So that, you know, at any one point in time, we're not exposed in the whole of our workforce to any risk.
Yep. So that's gone down an A and B shift.
Yep.
Adapt to how anyone else would do it.
Yep.
That way it is safer for everybody.
Yep.
And we can still service the community at the same time.
Yep. So it's been a bit of a dower for me driving in MacArthur, but one, I think, is very informative. One, because you're a great guy, and two, at this point in time, we need to use people like you to reassure people, and I'm hopeful we've done that in this process. So pretty shortly, we'll pull into the driveway, and we might set up a bomb, see how people can see it, and hopefully we can pick up the film. The film will pick up the droplets being dispersed and give everyone an understanding as to what that is. And again, we're more than happy to take any feedback on board in that regard.
Yeah, for sure.
I've realised I'm driving to the wrong workshop for this because you manage all of them, and I've got to go back to the other one, don't I? there you go.
A little bit longer.
Thanks for that, Gaz. Let's continue the journey outside the vehicle, shall we?
Shall do.
Cool. So guys, maybe if you could show everyone at home what we're doing for the steering wheels.
Sure.
So that's a plastic film wrap.
Yes, plastic film. Pretty much wrap it around.
And then the idea of that is we leave that on whilst we're servicing it, and we hand the vehicle over.
When we hand the vehicle over, so it stays on the whole time, and then when we hand the vehicle over, we take it off, and then we do another wipe down with the wipes.
Okay. So in my hot little hands, we've got another little device which we mentioned earlier, which is an antimicrobial bomb.
That's correct.
So what this does is we let it off in the vehicle, have the air conditioning system running. It then circulates the moisture, the droplets through the air, which land on the vehicle surfaces and forms a protective film.
Film over top.
Yep. Takes about 15 minutes to do.
Pretty much.
You want to show us how that works?
Sure.
That's awesome, guys. That's fully dispersed.
That it has.
Thanks for your time today.
No worries.
Catch you later.
Cheers.
We've got it.
You got it.